each of you in the house of her husband. Then she kissed them, and they lifted up their voice and wept. And they said unto her, surely we will return with thee unto thy people. And Naomi said, turn again, my daughters, why will ye go with me? Are there yet any more sons in my womb that may be your husband? Turn again, my daughters, go your way, for I am too old to have a husband. If I should say I have hope, if I should have a husband also tonight, and should bear sons, would he tarry for them to grow? Would he stay for them to from having husband? Nay, my daughters, for it grieveth me much for your sake, that the hand of the Lord is gone out against me. And they lifted up their voice and wept again, and Orpah kissed her mother-in-law, but Ruth cleaved unto her. And she said, behold, thy sister-in-law is gone back unto her people and unto her God. Return thou after thy sister-in-law. And Ruth said, entreat me not to leave thee or return from following after thee. For whither thou goest, I will go, and where thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God my God. Where thou diest, will I die, and there will I be buried. And the Lord do so to me and more also, if aught but death put thee and me. And when she saw that she was steadfastly minded to go with her, then she left speaking unto her. 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 2. Quickly. 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 2. Are you there? Are you in 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 2? If you are there, say, I am there. Alright, I read. Moreover, it is required in stewards that a man be found faithful. Lord, the flower fades and the grass withers, but your word abideth forever. Throw your weight around in this building and glorify yourself. In Jesus' name we pray. Sit down and never go down. Hallelujah. I want to talk to you briefly on what I have been asked to talk about, and it is a faithful woman of God. I want to share briefly on what we have titled, a faithful woman of God. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, before I start communicating anything to you, I just want to first of all allow you and make you know the meaning of faithful. To be faithful means to be steadfast. To be faithful means to stay put, to have stickability. Anybody that is faithful is someone that has stickability. Someone that is not ready to change against all odds. Someone that is ready to remain the way they are, no matter what happens to them. And the Bible says, from the second portion we read from, that it is required in steward that someone be found faithful. What does that tell me? Stewardship is equal to faithfulness. Am I communicating? In mathematics, we will say stewardship is directly proportional to faithfulness. And who is a steward? A steward is a manager. A steward is someone that is put in charge. A steward is someone that is given an affair to overlook, to oversee, to take care of. Brothers and sisters, my first submission this morning is to make every woman in this auditorium understand that you are a steward in life. The reason why God created a woman is because He wants you to oversee life. He wants you to manage life. He wants you to take care of situations. God has put so much in the hand of a woman. And this is why I disagree with the philosophy that says a woman is a weaker vessel. I have come to discover from the Bible, and I have come to discover by experience, that women are not weaker vessels. That place that we normally read, the Bible said a man should handle a woman like a weaker vessel. It did not say a woman is a weaker vessel. It said handle them like a weaker vessel. Why did God advise like that? Because you can't have two captains in worship. Am I communicating? This is the reason why God said, treat them as a weaker one. Because in every ship, there is a higher one and there is a weaker one. A woman is not a weaker vessel. If you look at womanhood, you will discover that a woman has the power and the ability to do things that a man cannot do. Am I communicating? That does not make them weaker. God just told them, take the place of weakness. Am I communicating? And this is where submission comes into play. Submission means someone that has authority but decided to put his authority under. Am I communicating? Treat them as one that is weaker. It didn't say you are weaker. I want every woman in this house to shout, I am not weak. Am I communicating? woman is not weak. That place said, treat them, handle them as if they are weak. Am I communicating? Why did God say that? I will share a revelation this morning, but I hope to stay in 30 minutes. You know, thank God for this church. We don't just come to quote John 3:16. Yeah. We look at things deeply.
Hallelujah.
Am I communicating?
Yeah.
He said, handle them as people who are weak. Honor them. Why? God has instructed them to submit. Am I communicating?
Yes.
He has instructed them to submit. So as they submit, you should see them like that. Not because they are weak. Every man that is thinking a woman is weak is deceiving himself. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Because you cannot assume. I pity for men that think they can treat women anyhow. Do you know the greatest blessing God left on earth is a woman? I will explain. The greatest blessing God left on the earth is a woman. God looked at a man after creating everything. He said, this one is not complete. It means after I complete 7 days, all God suffered to create was named incomplete. Why? Because someone was missing.
Hallelujah.
What does that tell me? That the earth is not complete until there is woman in the scene.
Hallelujah.
And a man can never say you are complete. It doesn't matter how much you have, you are not complete until there is a woman in your life. Am I communicating?
Yes.
And you see us men, we start doing as if we have power. That woman you are treating any year can kill you in 2 seconds without looking back. Do you even know, married men, listen to me, your life is in the hand of your wife. All those your clatter, your life is inside one pot of soup.
Right now, Pastor.
Am I communicating?
Yeah.
Only one pot of soup. If she put extra Maggi, you are gone. Extra. You're finished. Solomon, the most experienced man on earth when it comes to women's affairs. He was the minister of the whole world in women's affairs. He looked at a woman and he said, by the means of a whorish woman is a man reduced to a piece of bread. Man, with all your muscle, a woman can make you be like bread, fuku fuku. You think you are strong? Try a desperate woman. If you are not afraid of anything, fear women. No. When a woman wants to show you, she will go any length to destroy you. Am I communicating? The only thing that can conquer the strength of a woman is the grace of God.
Hallelujah.
Many men today have lost their destiny. Many men are struggling in life because they met a woman that they were not supposed to meet. Am I communicating? Every woman is a two-edged sword. A woman is a two-edged sword. The same woman that can be wealth unto men can also be wealth unto men. Am I communicating? A woman can be your curse and your downfall. The same woman can be your blessing and your greatness.
Hallelujah.
You must be wise not to take the woman in your life lightly. Am I communicating? Because God has decided that your life is not complete until you have a woman in your life. Can I even shock you? The beauty of every man's life is in how the wife looks. If you want to know if any man is happy, look at the wife. No matter how strong you are, if your wife is not happy, you cannot be happy. Am I talking to someone? If your wife is not happy, you can't be happy. Solomon said, it is better to go and spread mattress on top of a roof than to stay with a poor strong woman. That's somebody talking from experience. I'm married. Few months from now, it will be 8 years. It's not a yesterday thing. And there are many married men. A woman can bore you with quarrel. You will confuse. Am I communicating? That is why I pity for men who think there are better women out there. Am I communicating? has the ability to be a devil. Every woman has the ability to be an angel. Anyone you want to enjoy is what you bring out. Am I communicating? When you have a woman in your life, if you are smart, you bring out the angel in her. If you think you are wise, she will give you what it means to be a devil. Faithful woman of God. It is required a stewardship that everybody that has the responsibility of a steward must be faithful. How can you say a woman is weaker? Do you know when Jesus died, sir? When Jesus died, all the apostles ran. All of them disappeared. They went to lock themselves somewhere. It was three women that carried incense and went to the grave. And this grave, early in the morning, around 4 a.m., they went to the grave with incense. Soldiers were guiding the grave. It was in the cemetery. How can you call such people weak? Men took off. They went to hide. They took off. They went to hide. I pity for churches that keep saying that a woman cannot mount the pulpit. The first people that received the gospel, women. It was women, the angels gave the gospel to the apostles. He said, go and tell them that Jesus is risen. Who did he tell? Women. They were the first ministers of the gospel of resurrection.
Oh, yes.
They went to the cemetery very early in the morning while Peter and Co. with all their baby chests. They were hiding inside one room. Why? Because they didn't want to die. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The strength of every ministry is the women you have in the ministry. Jesus' ministry was a success because he had women that were attending to their needs.
Hallelujah.
Am I communicating?
Hallelujah.
His ministry was not complete. Look at the book of Luke. Let me show you something quickly. Look. Go to the book of Luke. Kola Masia. Luke chapter 8. Let me rush this thing. I can do justice to it. Luke chapter 8. If you want to succeed as a man, advise yourself. If you want to give yourself peace, love your wife.
Yes.
Because once the woman in your life is not happy, forget happiness. You will be pretending. You will become a storyteller. If you marry a good woman, you will shine. But if you marry a bad woman, you become a storyteller. Am I talking to someone? Are you in the book of Luke, chapter 8? Look at verse 1 to 3. He said that it came to pass, afterward, he went throughout every city and village preaching and showing the glad tidings of the kingdom of God. And the 12 were with him. And certain women which have been healed of evil spirit and infirmity, Mary called Magdalene, out of whom went out 7 demons, and Joanna, the wife of Chuza, Herod's steward, and Susanna, and many others, which ministered unto him with their substance. They were following him everywhere and they were ministering to him.
Hallelujah.
Am I communicating?
Everywhere.
Are you catching anything here?
Yes, sir.
A woman is the completion of a man. Is your mystery? God knows what he was doing. That is why he took a woman out of a man. So that until you find her, you are not complete. That's why the Bible said, he that finds a wife finds a good thing. A good thing. And one of the ways to know if you have a wife is, since you got married as a man, what kind of good things are you experiencing? That's how to know if you have a wife or a knife. Women, if your husband is not increasing since you entered his life, you are likely to be the problem. You are likely to be the problem. That's the truth. Because no man succeeds without the backing of the wife. Am I communicating? No man succeeds truly without the backing of the wife. You know, we are in Europe now and there are so many things that are happening. The women, they want to take charge. Am I communicating?
Yes.
And they are planning their own lives outside of their marriage. This is against the Bible and this is against your fulfillment. You can never be happy if you are planning life outside of. Listen to me. The person that you was not a husband, he was a boyfriend. You don't have anybody to blame. It's you, you have yourself to blame. You were treating your boyfriend like a husband. That is why they dupe you. The problem we have is many women enter into marriage with the mindset of what they suffered in the hands of a man before. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Let me show you scriptures. Your desire as a woman is towards your husband. You don't have any other life. As every good woman, this is not hard to do if you are a good woman. Am I communicating?
Yes.
It was God that arranged it like that. Every good woman's desire is towards her husband. If you are here as a woman, you are planning another life outside your marriage. You are the problem in that marriage. Am I communicating? You are the reason why your marriage is not working. But sir, this man is cheating on me. I don't trust this man. I don't know what the future holds for me. Brothers and sisters, you don't have to plan another life. Am I communicating? Every marriage is bound to work. Am I communicating with someone? And most of the responsibility is in the hand of the woman. I will prove it. I'm not in a hurry. Don't worry. Don't look at me like that. You can't beat me. I'm still the pastor here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Instead, the Bible said, a wise woman buildeth a home, but a foolish one with her own hands tears it down. You are always either of the two. Am I communicating?
Yes.
You are always either of the two. It's either you are wise or you are foolish. How can you tell me that the man is the problem when someone in the age of an Obasanjo, a young girl, can still be rubbing her head and Baba will be saying, Artists, killers, have women they respect.
Yes.
And you say a man is the problem. That man you are calling the problem can, and the man will be so submissive to the woman. The problem is that the other woman is doing what you refuse to do.
That's so.
You were pampering her by his money, like life. You were struggling authority in the house with him. And the other woman comes in before the husband asks for water. She runs with the water and kneels down. And you want him to treat men. Men like that kind of life. And side chick, they know how to play more than their wives. They won't marry you. They will be giving your husband what you refuse to give them. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
You know, there's something I noticed. If a woman leaves her husband's house, she becomes beautiful again.
That's so.
Experience chapter 23, verse 5. But if he's with that man at home, you will see her tie wrapper every day, everywhere. Am I communicating? But let there be problem, even if they are not talking. The woman has not even left home. If there is problem, that's why she knows how to wear skimpy jeans. You will see her go and make a very good hair. Why don't you make that hair every day? You want to cook, you will throw a pie here like this, and you enter the kitchen and be singing, oh, do, man. Was that how you used to do it when you were single? What's that? Oh, can you allow me to preach this morning? Should we close? Was that how you used to do it when you were single? When John was coming to your house, when you were not married, when you were still single, immediately you knew John was coming, you will run and go and wear push up jeans, and you will start shaking it around the house and start blowing whistle. Now you are married, you have started tying up, and your husband will soon leave you. But now, oh my God, marriage is very easy to work.
Yes.
Most times the women are the problem. That energy that you are using to complain, God did not give you to complain, is to work your marriage out.
Mm-hmm.
It's to work your marriage out. You don't want to be responsible for your husband, but you don't want to contribute to his greatness. I see many women who are married to great men in their training process. You see these women foolishly stressing their husband. For example, you are marrying a pastor who has a call upon his life. Instead of you to be pushing that man of God to pray every time, so that the anointing can come upon his life and God start blessing him, you are pushing him to go and hustle. The few years you will encourage him to pray and strengthen the grace upon his life, you are using it to look for 200 euros from his hand. You are not ready. Because there is no way he will become great without what he's doing now. His greatness is inside his calling. A wise woman will push his after the calling. But you know, some of us are pushing our husband away from the church. You are telling them he's spending too much time in the church. He doesn't have time for me. Why not allow him to spend so much time in the church for a few while? So that his calling can speak. And then you will start enjoying your life.
Amen.
I'm here today because I married the right woman.
Hallelujah.
Sure, but I like her like that. Oh yeah. A notebook. I showed her my notebook, my vision for life. I'm a man of God. And she told me I will support you.
Hallelujah.
When I am not praying, she is pushing me to pray. Everybody was pressurizing her. Your husband, he doesn't want to work. This and this, that and that. And of course, as a human being, those things will get to her sometimes. But she stood her ground and said no. When it's time to pray and I'm still sleeping, she will come and meet me. You are not praying. That is how I got here. Not telling me to go and hustle with that paper. Go and sell paper. You don't have document. Go and sell paper. We would have still been selling paper till now.
Oh.
If she was not wise, I would have still been selling paper. Okay, maybe now I have document now. I will be moving from one lager to another.
Hey.
Just last month, I received some people's 4 months salary in a day.
Hallelujah.
Your 4 months salary in a day. Why? Because I attended to this call, and this call is taking care of me now.
Amen.
She was wise to know this, and she helped me to pursue the call.
Amen.
Support your husband to fulfill your dream. It's not this woman that I'm now that is the issue. Manage for a while. And every great man of God I have seen, I don't know why God is leading me in this direction. Maybe there are some of you here that their husbands are supposed to be ministers. Every great man of God that I have seen, their husband, their wives were responsible for them at the beginning. Every great man on earth must have the input of the wife. A good woman must learn to support the husband.
Amen.
How much can he give you? Why not wait? Why not support him till he is able to give you what can make you happy?
Amen.
Am I making sense this morning?
Yes.
Are you still here?
Yes.
There are two things that is required of women. There are only two things that God requires from every woman. If you can get these two things right, your life will be full of joy. Submission, number one. Every woman must learn to be submissive. This idea of we are in Europe and gender equality is foolishness from hell. Am I communicating? If you think I'm lying, go and ask European men. None of them is married anymore. That is why you see clubhouses and prostitution joints flourishing in Europe. Why? Because their men are no longer interested in marriage. Because of this issue, they prefer to go and service themselves when they have need, when they have a sexual desire. Nothing equal about gender. As a matter of fact, when a woman knows herself, she is stronger and greater than the man. God just put authority in the man's hand, but the woman is stronger. Enormous power is in their hand. They are fighting for what is not fighting for them, and they have lost out of their place. Hallelujah. Number two. If as a woman you are able to submit your desire into your plans, into the plans of your husband, you will know joy forever.
Amen.
Let me show you scripture. Go to Genesis. Which one should I read first now? Okay, 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Let's look at 1 Corinthians 11. I want to round up. I don't have time. They've timed me. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Are you there?
Yes.
Oh Lord, thank you. I hope I'm making sense this morning. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Look at verse 8. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man. Neither was the man created for the woman, but the woman for the man. I will explain. Let me read the scriptures first. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 34. Flip it over to chapter 7 and read. Let's read verse 34. Are you there? He said there is difference also between a wife and a virgin. The unmarried woman careth for the things of the Lord, that she may be holy both in body and in spirit. But she that is married careth for the things of this world, how she may please her husband. Is that in your Bible?
Yes.
The joy of your husband is your fulfillment. That's why you came in the first place. Am I communicating?
Yes.
And men must understand that when a woman so cares for you and is